Hello everyone. In this session, we will go through a review of objects and classes, just like a review of concepts you did in Java 1 about how to have classes and how to have objects of classes. Once we know how to declare classes and how to deal with objects, then we can move easily with the topics in ITCS114 when we have to declare arrays, objects, arrays of objects, and so on. So let's start with this example, which says, let's assume the following. I will have a class student, and for each student, I will have a private long ID, private double GBA. The meaning of a private, it means that ID and GBA are members, private members, and they can be used only inside the student class. So it's more like I'm protecting the ID and the GBA. They are not used outside the class. And then we will have public void set student. It will take long new ID, double new GBA. The meaning of this, the aim of this method is to set the data. So I will take the new ID and I will save it in ID, and I will take the value of the new GBA and save it in GBA. So originally I have variables ID and GBA, and then we will take new ID, for example, new ID is 11, a new GBA is 3.5. I have to take these values and save it in the ID, and I have to save it in the GBA. That's why we say ID equals the new value, GBA equals the new value. Just like you have set method, you have get method as well. With get method, we have it as a public method. If I have to retrieve ID, I will call the method getID, and it will return long. And the coding I have to decide is return ID. So it means go to my ID, what is the value, and just return it. That's why we have the data type of long for this method. If I need to return GBA, I'll have to say public double GBA, because double as the type of GBA, and simply we will have to say return GBA. Here we have a printing method. It says public void print. Void, it means we are not returning any value. All what I'll have to do is system.out.println ID space and GBA. So go and output what is the current value of ID, what is the current value of GBA. And this is the end of our class. So in this class, we have two private members, ID and GBA, and as we mentioned, they can be accessed only inside the class student. And then I have public method. Public method, it means we can access them outside the class. I have a method set, and the main aim of set is to access the data member and change their values. I have get ID and get GBA to retrieve the value of ID and GBA. So it's more like I'm asking question, what is your ID? What is your GBA? Additionally, we have a void method print. It will output the value of the ID and the GBA. Now, just like you notice, we don't have a main method in this class. So in order to compile and run our program, we need a main method. So I will go and create another file. I will call it public class student class demo. And then I will have my main method, public static void main. And then the first statement it says, go and create an object named st1 of type student. The way to create this object, I will say student, st1 equals new student. So actually what we are doing, we are saying, let's have an object, the name of the object st1. And this is as an object, it's not like a normal integer or double value. It is of type students. That's why we say here student, the name of the object st1 equals new student. So go and create this object st1 to be of this class, of a student class, which means you should have the private members and the public method. So inside st1, I should have ID, I should have GBA as a private member, and also I should have all the public methods set, get, and print. Now, I have a statement that says, go and set ID and GB of ST1 to the following values. In order to change the values of ID and GB of a specific object, I have to use a method. Now, we have three methods. We have the set method, will change the value, and we have get method, will retrieve values, and we have a printing method, this is only as an output. In order to change the values, I have to use the set method. So what I will say, I will have to say, go to my object st1 dot set student, and this is the name of my method, this is set student, and send two values, 2017, 1234, and then comma 3.5, this is for GBA. So the way it will work in this case, it will say, call this method, send the values, so it will take two values, 2017, 1234, this is for new ID, and 3.5, this is for a new GBA. What is expected inside this method? I have to do the following. I'll have to say ID equal a new ID. ID, it means you are referring to the object you are calling the method from. I'm referring now to which object? To object ST1. So I have to say, go to the object ST1, and the ID should be initialized to 2017, 1234, and then go to the GBA and should initialize it to 3.5. So you will go there and we will say this is 3.5. Now we can see the meaning of set method. Set method actually will take values and save it, store it inside our object. Once we are done with this step, we can go to the other step in the main method. So now it says, go and output ST1 ID and GBA. So we will have a message, print ST1 ID and GBA. In order to do the printing of the ID and GBA inside ST1, we cannot do the printing directly because ID and GBA, they are private inside the student. So in order to do the output, I have to use the method print. So I will say, st1.print, and this is will access or will call the printing method. It will say output ID space GBA, which ID, which GBA, the ID and the GBA of the calling object, which is st1. So here as an output, I will output the ID stored inside st1, which is 2017, 1234. And then we will have a space, and then we will have the GBA, which is 3.5. Now, as with all programming, as with all applications you do, usually you will have many objects, not one object. So here it says here, go and create another object, ST2 of type student. So I will apply the same concept. I will say student, the name of my class, the name of the object ST2 equals a new student. So I'm saying, let's have ST2 as another object. And this object, I should have all the private and public methods we have in a student, which is private ID and GBA, and public method, which are the set, get, and print. Now we have to be careful that ST1 and ST2, both of them, they are of type class student, but actually they are having different values. So the ID in ST1 is different than the ID in ST2. Now here what we will do, we will ask the user to enter values of ID and GBA of ST2. So as usual, we have a scanner. So we will say scanner read new scanner system.n. I will declare two variables, ID and GBA. So I will have here a variable ID within this application, a variable GBA. And then I will ask the user, please enter student ID. I will read the ID. Let's assume the ID is 11. I will ask the user for GBA. I will read the GBA. For example, the GBA is 1.5. Now, my job is I have to take the values that I did the reading inside my application and I have to save them inside ST2. In order to save, in order to change, we mentioned that the only method I can use is set. So the way I'll have to mention, I'll have to say go to ST2 dot, call the method setStudent, and here I have to send ID and GPA. So it will go there and it will send the value. What is the value of ID, which is 11? What is the value of GPA, which is 1.5? So they will be sent as a new ID and a new GPA. I will take these values and I just have to save them over there. So this is 11 and this is 1.5. So the idea here, if you need to read values from the user and save it in an object, we cannot do this directly. The only way I have to do it is by declaring variables, read the values and save the values inside these variables, and then call setStudent or the set method to save your values. Once you are done with saving your value, if you need to print the ID and GB of a student too, simply you can say st2.print, just like what we did with the first object. If you would like to print only the ID of the object, just like here it says, do the output of st2id. So I will say system.out.print st2.getID. So it says, go to the method getID, which is this method. And this method, I have only one statement, return ID. So it will take the value and return it to the main method. So the value of the ID, I have to be careful which object I am talking about. I am talking about the object ST2. So it means I have to go to the object ST2. The value of the ID is 11. So it means that we will return the result here as 11. And the output in this case will be 11. We cannot do the output directly. I cannot just say system.out.print ST2.id because ID is private. And we cannot do the access of the elements directly. So just to recap, to make sure that we know the concepts we discussed here, let's get these out of the side. So here, when we started, we said, always you should start with your class. So I will have my class as a student. Any members, ID, name, GBA, address, major, always we declare them as private. So always I have to say private, what is their data type, and then what is the name. And then always you will have methods, which are the set method and the get method. For the set method, always they are void method, and they are public. So I'll say public void, and then I'll give it a name. I can say setStudent, setData, whatever the naming. And then I should have the parameters. So for example, in the private, I have ID and GBA. Here I will have long new ID, double new GBA. If in the private, I have ID, GBA, and name, I can say long new ID, double new GBA, string new name. So whatever parameters we have, variables as private members, we should have them in the set method. Now, inside the set method, what you should have? You should have the private member equal the parameter. So ID equals a new ID. Remember, the private member ID equals the parameter a new ID. Do not do the opposite thing. Do not say a new ID equal ID. It will give you a different meaning. Just like you should be able to change the value, you should be able to retrieve. That's why you need get method. So here we have public long get ID and it will return the ID. I have to return ID and ID of type long. That's why I have the method as public and the return type as long. The other one, GB of type double, I have it public and I have double. I will call it get GBA and I will return the GBA. We have additional method printing. This is only to do the output. If I need to run my program, always I have to write the main method, and we will declare objects. Remember, the objects should be the same data type of your class. So if this is a student with capital S, when you declare your object, it should be student with capital S as well. If you need to change the value, you have two ways, either by having the values as they are, or by having to read the values from the user. But in both cases, I have to say set. So I'll have to say set student with values, or I can ask the user to enter the values. I have to save them in variables, and then I will say set student with the values.